Hey everyone, today we're going to be taking a look at Google Earth and how you can use it as a tool to do research on the history of a property. So if you're buying land or you've already bought land, you want to find out what happened before you owned it, I'm going to show you how to do that. We're also going to show you how we found a septic system that we didn't know where it was exactly located by using this exact tool. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we have Google Earth Pro pulled up here right now. I want to be real clear on something right off the bat here is you got to make sure that you actually download the desktop version of Google Earth Pro in order to get the history feature that we're going to talk about today. So you cannot get this by going into your browser and just going to the online version. So make sure that you go and you download this on your desktop, and then you'll be able to get access to this. So I want to give you a little bit of direction on what we're looking at here. So this little feature here that has a time lapse where it goes back in time, you kind of see the circle right here. That's what we're looking at. That's the history feature that you want to look at here, okay? So this down here gives you the address of the property that you're looking at. And what I did was I typed that in over here and then hit the search button, or I typed it here actually, then hit the search button and then it pops up here and then it shows you it right here. So that's what you're seeing here is the property. Property address, and then you're going to be typing it in and searching here. Okay. So this particular property is in Middleton, Idaho that we're looking at here. So what you're seeing is this is north, you know, north is how this pops up. It's where you're looking at it from that direction. If you go over here to the right, and you may not be able to see this because my picture in the way here, but you can see this, you can grab this and move around and spin north. You know, you can spin around, so you can take look at different angles of these of the property once you get this up. Okay, so that's something you can do. Now, what the time lapse you're looking at these, so these are is always going to default to the most current picture that's been taken by the satellites that are on here, and that's what we're looking at here. So this property has a home on it that needs to be torn down, and that's what this you're seeing here. And there's you'll get some history of this, but you're going to find out that there was trailers in here that were tied in. And there's also some over here, a bunch of junk that was removed off here, trailers and junk. So what our goal with this time lapse was, we went back and looked and we were looking for the septic system. So inside the house, there's a clean out in here, but there was no clean out that could be located outside the home as far as finding out, you know, where does that clean out go? And there's a slab here. So it's not on a subfloor where you get in there and actually look and see where the pipes are going. So what we ended up doing was we went to this history tab, clicked on this history here. You can see 8/2021 was the last picture that was taken here. So as you go back, each one of these lines that you can see right here is another picture. So you can see this here. This looks to be like it's in the wintertime where there's no leaves in any of the trees. And you can see this house here that was there. So as you go back, you can start to see some of these pictures are actually better quality than others. Back 2018, you can see it's a lot better. So there's this is a picture. You can see the home is deteriorating here. If we go back, I'm gonna jump all the way back here. I want you to see this in 10 of 2002. Okay, this is the image here that we were able to tell a lot what was going on. So this had this is the mobile home that was in here on this property at this point right here. And then there's also there's another mobile home that was back here. And then there's an old. This is actually appears to be an old, possibly a barn that actually burned down. That's here, but what we're seeing here is a shop, and this is the house. So you can see the roof is still in the house. So the house is very deteriorated at this point right now. It needs to be torn down because the roof was torn off of it. It was tin. I think it was vandalized. But what you're seeing here, right, this green area right here, okay, this is where the leach lines are at for the septic system. So by looking at this aerial of this history map, we're able to see that this is where the septic system was at. So what we did was we were able to kind of come back in here. This has started a leach field. We got to have our septic tank back over in this area here. So we were able to locate the septic tank here or a clean out here by digging around. And then we were able to dig down from there and find the septic tank that is here, which appears to be in good condition. So it can be utilized. So what we're, by looking back at this history, we're able to locate this. And I want to show you a couple other examples of this. And you can go, so here's 10 of 2003. Let's see if we go back a little bit. Skipping over them, but you can still see the trailers are still there. I have a note here of the date. So 6 of 2005, is you can still see the green because this house got abandoned. I want you to see it. So you can still see the area of the septic, the leach field that's right here. You still see the roof is on here. The trailers are still here that are on the property, the mobile homes. So those are all there. It appears that people are still living here. So if you go, and then if we move back to 6 of 2007, these mobile homes have now been moved off the property, and you can see that the leach field is not green. So there's been no water, there's no usage. So that would appear to me that this house has been abandoned at that point. This is, no one's been utilizing this because this more than likely is tied into this system down here, is what we're seeing in the piping system. This was, there's a line running down here to tie back into the septic here, and then you utilize that leach field. And we still have not figured out where the leach field, if there was something that had been put in here to, or if that was tied in. There's quite a bit of fall going over here, so it's possible there's a tie in there, but it appears that it's abandoned because you can't find this. So at this point, you could not find the leach field based on what we did by looking at the green areas. But now that the home, or when someone's occupying the home, we can see it. So you can see here, just to give you an example of what occurs down the road, is this home, now it was abandoned, you start to see deterioration. So this was vandalized, the home was actually in pretty good shape. And then the roof got torn off, as the story we were told from the neighbors, and then things just started deteriorating. It's the shop, same scenario, tin was pulled off, and then just started to rot away. So actually from 2007 till today, it's become a complete tear down of the house because it's just because of losing the roof and being in the weather. So, but you can see, and there's still a continuation. There's no green here because that septic system has not been utilized since 2007. So, and then you can see the progression of these images as they go. They tend to get better. There's a few of them that are actually not quite as good, but as the years go on, they get better and better satellite images that are going on. You can tell when it's winter versus actually springtime, just based on the trees losing their leaves and whatnot. So, all right, so that is how we actually found the septic system on this property utilizing the Google Earth history feature. So make sure again that you go back and you actually download the desktop version of this, and then you can take a look at, you know, the property with different time frames all the way back. You can see what they, a lot of times it helps, like this one, if you go all the way back to 85, you can see where there's roads. You know, if you go down this, when these roads were cut, you can see that as well. And then remember also that up at the top, I'll show you an example of this. You grab up here, top right-hand corner. You might not be able to see it because my video image might be over the top of that, but you can spin this and you can get some good angles going down, and it really helps to do that. Like, I'll go back and let me show you this. We'll take a look at this back in 2007. So there you go. That's 2010. Sorry, 2010. And then let's jump back to these dates when they actually abandoned this. So you can see 2007. So there, it's empty. You can still see a little bit of the green was in 2005. So that one's out. So we knew at that point they were gone. So let's take a look at this. So there's the green. There's the one we're looking at. 2005. Still see the mobile homes that are in here. There it is. And let's go back and we'll look at the other ones a little bit cleaner in 2002. So you can see us again, 10 of 2002. So there it is. So there's the green. There's people living in this, and this, I believe this line is tying in here and then utilizing that system. So, all right. So that is a quick overview on how to use Google Earth to look at the history of your property. So another thing you can utilize the history of Google Earth is to actually look up on a property and see if structures are permitted or not. So a lot of times you'll look at a old home and it's been added onto a number of times, and you won't be able to actually find records of the permits down at the county or the city building departments. And one thing you can do is actually go back and look at these images and see when was the original roof there and when was the new one possibly added. And that'll give you a timeline of what you can actually do to look for records and determine if something was permitted. So that's another thing you can use Google Earth for that can help you. So, all right, so hope that was helpful. If you'd like more information about building, buying, or selling your home or land, visit our website, go to our resources tab at realpropertytv.com. So thanks again for your time. It was wonderful talking to you.